Bossk collectors, and welcome to another Bossk's Bounty video, and welcome to another video where me and my son Little Bossk are going to be opening up older Star Wars figures whilst everyone is in lockdown still. I think a lot of people are still in lockdown. Things are getting better in the UK, but I realize in other countries things are still pretty bad, and every so often there seems to be a flare-up of this awful thing that's still going around, and little places here and there get put into lockdown. So we're still going to be opening up older figures, doing videos. We love doing this. My son loves opening the figures. So drop a like down below for Little Bossk and comment down below on the figures that we're going to be opening and which figure we're going to be opening up first.
The Ugnaught.
Okay, so we're going to be opening up this Ugnaught. This is the brown Ugnaught, and this was a gift from Jeff in California. So thank you very much once again, Jeff. We're going to be opening up this figure first. We do also have three other figures that we're going to be opening up today. We have a Black Series 3.75 inch. We have a Saga Legends figure, and we also have a very cool figure from the Order 66 2-pack, which I'm looking forward to opening. So stay tuned as we open up all these figures, and Little Bossk can tell you what he thinks of them all. All right, so first we're going to be taking a look at the brown Ugnaught. He is from the Legacy Collection. There is the back of the box, and we do have the other Ugnaught to compare him to, the blue Ugnaught. And of course, as you can see, this is the Legacy Collection, so it's the Build-A-Droid series. And you actually get the body of R3-M3 in this particular figure. And of course, there's some other figures that you could get at the bottom of the packet there, including that pretty cool ARC Trooper. Now, as with the blue Ugnaught from the Legacy Collection, you do get a little control panel. And Little Bossk noticed something about that control panel, didn't you?
They both have the same control panel and toolbox.
So they have exactly the same control panel and the toolbox as well. Is that right? Let's have a look. So there's the Ugnaught, that's the brown Ugnaught, and he's got his little toolbox there. And this is the blue Ugnaught, and he also, yep, you're right, Little Bossk, he has exactly the same toolbox. And what else have you noticed about the Ugnaughts?
They also both have the same gloves.
They do, yeah, they have exactly the same gloves, don't they? So Hasbro using some of the parts there. Awesome to have these two Ugnaughts. I think I prefer the blue one. He's more like the vintage one that you've got, and I do like his little apron. But both of these are going to go very nicely with the carbon freezing diorama that we're getting pretty soon. Actually, I think we're going to be getting that. So these two Ugnaughts from the Legacy Collection are, you know, must haves for that set, I guess. But this little brown Ugnaught here, he's really good actually. I think I might prefer the head sculpt of this one, but then I prefer the body of this one. Yeah, they are really different actually, aren't they? This one's much more pig-like. What do you think of him?
I think he looks great.
You like him, do you? Okay, right, on to the next figure. Okay, next up, the next figure that we're going to be opening is the Snowtrooper from the Saga Legends line. This is SL23 in the line. It's one of these figures where you get the stand and the extra bag of weapons. And the year on this one is 2009. And really excited to get this figure out of the package because he is a repack of the Saga, Vintage Saga Collection 1, so on the Vintage Style card. He's a repack of that figure. And he is going to be a lot better than the Black Series figure that they brought out, which is this one here. This is the Snowtrooper Commander, I think, or a Sergeant or something. He's a higher rank. And this one's got like a plastic Karma, is it Karma they call them, or skirt, whatever you want to call that. It's plastic, whereas on this one it's soft goods, and I just much prefer this one. There's a lot more weathering going on in this guy. So we're going to be opening up this one, and we're going to compare him to this one here. As always with these Saga Legends figures, you get this little battle card thing which goes in the back of the stand, and a bag of extra weapons, which is always quite handy. But we're here to look at the figure, and here he is, the Snowtrooper. And I really like this Snowtrooper. He's really good. As I mentioned, he's got the soft goods skirt there, much better than the other one. And I also prefer the helmet as well. And the difference is with this one is actually this is a removable helmet. And what did you notice about that head?
The head almost looks like Jango Fett.
It does, doesn't it? It looks like the sort of clone head that they've used. But I do like the figure. Lots of battle damage going on his armor there and everything. Pretty cool. And I do like the the different colours that they've gone for with the helmet and the rest of the body. That's a bit more screen accurate for me. This one just seems far too white, and the helmet just, I'm not sure if that looks right really. I think possibly maybe somewhere between the two would be perfect, although as I say, I do much prefer this guy. I think the paintwork that they've used on this figure is a lot better than this one. This one's just too shiny and bright, and that's not how they were in the film. Their sort of undergarment was a different colour to the armour, which this one represents a lot better. Also, what did you notice about his boots?
His boots have mud on it and the other one doesn't.
Yeah, so as I say, this one's all really clean, and this one's, you know, battle hardened. He's been through it, hasn't he? So bit of weathering on his legs there, which is pretty cool. One thing that we have noticed about this figure is that if you turn him around, he does have that hole on his back, suggesting that there should be a backpack for him. And indeed there should be, because if you look at the blister tray there, there's a big space for the backpack, and my figure has not come with the backpack. And if you look at the carded version, which came out in the Saga collection in what, 2006-7, he has the backpack there. So that is very odd. So if anyone can tell me that has got one of these figures that they've opened from the Saga Legends line that didn't get the backpack also, or have I just got a dodgy one? Because I'm finding that really weird that he should come with that backpack. Anyway, that's enough about the Snowtrooper. We're going to now open the next figure. All right, next up we have a two-pack from the Order 66 line. This is the Mace Windu and Galactic Marine. And the reason I bought this is really just for the Galactic Marine. I do have a little mini army of the other Galactic Marines, the 30th anniversary one, which is the sort of purpley mauve coloured one. This one is white with purple armor pieces, and he looks mega cool. So we're going to open this one up and we're going to get him out of the package. And as I say, that's pretty much the only reason why I've got this two pack. Not too bothered about the Mace Windu figure, although he doesn't actually look too bad, but I don't think he's going to be a patch on the vintage collection version. But we'll get him out anyway and we'll take a look. Okay, so here's the Galactic Marine out of the package, and man, have I waited a long time to get this figure. He is really, really good. Of course, if we're to compare him against the standard 30th anniversary Galactic Marine, you can see the difference in colour, but it's obviously the same mould and sculpt and everything. Both have the removable helmets, so this guy, remove his helmet there. Very pale looking fella, that one. Let's see if he matches this one though. He doesn't. You can really see the difference. But they've still got the same head, but just painted differently. Bit of a shame they didn't use the sort of normal clone head. But to be honest, I'm not really going to display him with the helmet off. But this is a really, really nice Galactic Marine. Now, I'm not really too sure how to display this one. I'm thinking I will probably display him with my other Galactic Marines. But at the same time, he could easily go with the Mace Windu Attack Battalion battle pack, where you get some of the Phase 2 clones and an airborne trooper type guy in this colour scheme, like the Mace Windu colour scheme. So he's just awesome. He does actually come with a backpack included in the package this time. He's got some awesome markings on his little skirt there. And I just love the paint scheme on this guy. What do you think of him? Do you like him?
The white Galactic Marine is kind of like the purple Galactic Marine, except the white Galactic Marine is backwards.
he's backwards in colour. I see what you mean, yeah. Purple where there's white and all that, yeah. But yeah, these two look awesome. As I say, it's been a long time, me trying to get this figure. The Order 66 two-packs in the UK are quite expensive, but I managed to pick it up on eBay in the US and ship it to a friend, John, from the Super Awesome Geek Show. And he sent it over for me with a number of other things I bought from the US. It just seems to be cheaper that way. But he's really cool. Also in that two-pack, you get the Mace Windu figure, which we have here. And he is one of these figures that has the sort of battle motion when you squeeze his legs. He kind of does that, which for me really isn't necessary. But that head sculpt is actually not too bad. not a bad figure. I do like the robe. It's a decent robe. But I think the Vintage Collection version is loads better than this one. But it's not a bad effort, really. You wanted this one, didn't you?
Yeah.
All right. I think you can have this figure. Because you like the battle motions as well. You had the other one from the two-pack as well, didn't you? The Anakin.
Yeah.
So there you go. Alrighty, so we've got one more figure to open in this video, and it's a 3.75-inch Black Series. Alright, so the final figure that we have to open is a 3.75-inch Black Series. It's the orange line card, and it's number 16, Clone Commander Neo. This is a figure that my son has had for a while loose. You could pick these up in the Entertainer for like £3.75. Then I think they went up to about a fiver each. I did have one, but I gave it to my son, and then I realised that I don't have one loose myself. So we're going to open this one, and this one's going to go straight into my Clone Army collection that I have going on. So let's get him out. Black Series packaging really did nothing for me at all. It's, you know, a lot of these figures should have been just Vintage Collection figures, and they should never have really stopped it. And I'm not really sure why they did that. But still, let's get the figure open. He looks pretty decent, and we'll take a quick look. Here he is, Commander Neo. Got him in a pretty good pose there. He does have the ball-jointed hips, so you can sort of get him into some half-decent poses. Of course, he's carrying his helmet there. The helmet isn't actually too oversized, which is quite good. And he does have that sort of tattoo down his cheek, as you can see there. Decent-looking figure. Complete wash over him, which is really good. Makes him all look battle-hardened, if you like. Really nice figure. And, yeah, say, decent one to have in the collection. And what have you got to say about him?
I know he's a figure of mine, but I think he's still a really cool figure.
Okay then, so we have opened five figures if you include the one that was a two-pack. So we've had Commander Neo. Just put him down there quickly. We've had the Galactic Marine, the white and purple version. That also came with Mace Windu. And we also had the Ugnaught. Thank you for little Bossk. There's the Ugnaught from the Legacy Collection. And we also had the Snowtrooper. There he is. So there you go then, guys. That is myself and my son, little Bossk, just taking time out on Bank Holiday Monday to open some more older figures for our collections. I hope you've enjoyed the video. Don't forget to drop a like down below. And we shall see you on the next one.